Montleon, and I'm going to be your host for Dormet Dining Exercise Edition. My goal here is to get you guys exercising and being able to do it in your dorm rooms with no equipment that you need to buy and in as little amount of time as possible. So, before we start, we're going to have a few disclaimers. Make sure that you speak with a physician before you begin any exercise program. As well as speaking to a physician, also keep in mind that I am not a registered certified personal trainer. I am working on my certification, however, I do not have it yet. So, with that being said, let's begin.
Welcome to Dormet Dining Exercise Edition.
Today we're going to be doing four different exercises over the course of 50 seconds each with as many reps as possible within each of those 50 seconds. And we're going to repeat those over for 12 rounds total. Our first exercise is going to be a push-up and a bag drag. So find something heavy, stick it in your backpack, and have it by your side. My backpack weighs about 35 pounds, but for this you can use anything. And it may be a little bit different depending if your floor is hard or if you have carpet. So we're going to get down into the push-up position. Make sure your arms are underneath your shoulders, nice and straight. You've got a nice straight body line. And we're just going to do a push-up. And we're going to reach the opposite hand under our body and drag the back through. And we're going to go back, do another push-up, grab the bag, and drag it back. This is going to work our core as well as our upper body. For our next exercise, we're going to be doing wood choppers. Once again, you're going to need your bag or something heavy. Pick it up by the sides, get a good grip on it, and get your feet in a nice wide squat stance. You're going to take your bag, put it directly out in front of you, and sweep it down to the side, bringing your feet almost into a side lunge position, making sure your knees don't go over your toes. You're going to come up and twist, and bring the bag up over your head. The next exercise is going to be the exact same thing, but for the other side. Remember that you're going to want to track your bag with your head and your eyes so that you keep your head in alignment with your neck and with your back. And remember, if your bag is too heavy right now, you can always just do it with your hands. Same idea, but no weight. Down to the side. Twist it up. For our last exercise, we're going to be doing bicycles. Now remember for these, it's really important to take it nice and slow and make sure you get good solid movement throughout your entire core. It's really easy to go a little too fast with these and try to bang them out as fast as possible, but the slower the movement, the better work you'll get on your muscle. And remember, if you don't have a mat, just get a towel and fold it up and put it underneath your back. So you're going to put your hands behind your ears. Don't put it behind your head because you don't want to tug on your head. So put your hands behind your ears and you're just going to bring your opposite elbow to your opposite knee. You want to make sure that you go all the way down with each movement. And if you want to amp up the pressure a little bit, keep your feet off the ground. Straight leg, never letting your heels touch. So there's your four exercises. So repeat those through, 50 seconds each, 10 seconds rest in between for 12 rounds total. Good luck, guys.